Hi, my name is Toby Fischer, and today I'm going to talk about RoboStack, using the robot operating system alongside the Conda and Jupyter data signed ecosystems. Or the alternative title that I like a bit more, taking the horror out of ROS. Now, what is ROS? We are at a robotics conference, so most people should be familiar with it. But just as a recap, ROS is this amazing framework which allows you to interact with many, many robotic systems, simulate those robots, log data and debug data, visualize things, analyze stuff, and deploy many things to hardware. But what are the shortcomings of ROS? As we know, ROS is mostly tailored towards the Ubuntu Linux system. And in RoboStack, we developed a cross-platform binary distribution of ROS packages that runs on Windows, Linux, OS X, and importantly on any Linux system, even if it's 10 years old. What's the other cool thing? You can install many scientific and educational software side by side with ROS. So installing TensorFlow, PyTorch, Cassati, or OpenCV, it's now a matter of a simple installation command, and you get most recent software. We built RoboStack on top of Conda, an open source cross-platform package manager. So Conda is something similar to apt in Ubuntu or pip, in which you can install Python packages. But with Conda, binaries run natively, so really, really fast. And it's language agnostic. So it's not just Python. It's also C++, Java, Rust, Go, and so on and so forth. Conda is also an environment manager, so similar to virtualenv. Therefore, for each experiment that you do, you can have separate Conda environments, which helps you to separate out those different environments. And if one environment breaks, then the other environments will still work. You can also share environments with your colleagues and friends, which makes development really, really easy. And in robotics, it allows reproducible robotics. So if you publish a paper and you've got your ROS package there, you can reproduce the very same environment even years later on a completely different machine, which is really, really cool. In particular, we built on top of Condaforge, which is a community maintained package website. You get bleeding edge scientific software. So it's widely successful in machine learning, data science, physics, and so on and so forth. And bots do a lot of the work for you. There's a lot of robotics packages on Condaforge. So the point cloud library, scikit-image, gazebo, dart, bullet, and so on and so forth. The Python toolbox for robotics, and here from the QT Center of Robotics. And one of the cool things that we introduced with the RoboStack is a member. So if you used Conda before a while back, you would have noticed that it's quite slow to use. Member is a drop-in replacement for Conda that's really, really fast and works really well with hundreds of packages, as is the case for ROS. So ROS was one of the main motivations in developing member, where everything is parallelized and super fast. You can install member easily using member forge. And another huge advantage of member is that it displays really meaningful information if there are conflicts, which again, in Conda, you would have noticed has taken you a long time. So RoboStack is a ROS package for everyone and everywhere. So as I said before, you can install it on Windows, on Apple, on Linux. Your students can easily install it. It's just really, really nice and easy to install on a variety of platforms, including a Pine phone and a Steam Deck, and many more, including Raspberry Pis, and so on and so forth. So how can you install it? Installing ROS the easy way is now a simple matter of installing memberforge, as I described before, and then a single command, member create minus n, then the name of the environment, whichever ROS packages you want, and you need to specify the channel, which is RoboStack. Then you simply activate this environment and you can execute all kinds of ROS. So you can simply type RViz or whatever you like, which will install those packages. Once you have this package, you can install, remove, or update more packages in your environment or reproduce environments, as I said earlier. Now, if you focus for a moment on the bottom left on the slide, you would have maybe noticed that I'm running a terminal there. And indeed, I installed RViz while I was talking about RoboStack in the last three slides within less than a minute and a half. Which packages are available in RoboStack? There's a huge number of ROS packages available, but not all yet. Most important, all the desktop full, move it, and the navigation stack is available for ROS1 Noetic, ROS2 Galactic, and ROS2 Humble, and more to come. So in addition, RoboStack enables unique opportunities such as coupling ROS with the Jupyter platform and JupyterLab. So here you see how you can simulate a panda robot in JupyterLab and control it. We can also create some standalone widgets in the browser, so you can very nicely demonstrate and execute some commands on your robot simply by pulling up your Firefox or whatever your favorite browser is. And also, it's really, really easy to integrate more robots. So RoboStack is ready for the spot. How can you use RoboStack, you might ask yourself. You can contribute and you can let us know which packages you want to use, but are currently missing. You can integrate RoboStack in your CI pipelines. So you can now very easily check whether your package builds also on Windows or macOS. You can use it. So whether you're an educator, researcher, or developer in industry and academia, RoboStack is really, really cool. You can read more and cite our Robotics and Automation Magazine article. I'd like to send a thank you to all of our co-authors and collaborators, in particular, Sean Yan, Wolf Vollprecht, Silvio Traversaro, Lou Amadio, Stephen Ragnarok, and Tolly Foote. Thank you very much. For more info, check our website or join us on GitHub. Bye.